Hello everyone, this is Charlie and I am back with another week of comic book reviews. This week I only have four books and a back issue which I talked about getting last week. We'll get to it fast, so let's hope this is a quick video. So first off, we have Action Comics number 962. I actually like this cover. It kind of reminds me, like, brings full circle with the first cover, which was, I believe, 1957, with, you know, Superman carrying the like a boulder with the words Action Comics written on it. Now we have maybe sort of like mountain, you know, with the Superman fighting Doomsday. So this is the last part of the first arc. The conclusion of the first arc with the fight with Doomsday. So a lot of complaints I've heard about, you know, this first arc is way too much Doomsday, you know, a never ending battle with Doomsday. And yeah, I kind of agree, you know, there's too much Doomsday and really sort of seems like repetitive, no point, you know, just having issue after issue battling Doomsday. But you know, truly really the small moments, I mean, you have to really look at the small moments in this entire arc to actually enjoy it. I mean, yes, it's Doomsday, this is the Doomsday that actually killed this Superman back in 1992, but he's a bit different in the sense that he seems to have a bit of intelligence. Sort of during the battle, he sort of seems faster, a bit smarter, sort of has a strategy, sort of knows how to counteract Superman's attacks. But at the same time, unlike the first Doomsday battle, death is not an option like it was before. It also shows the experience Superman has, that he knows exactly what to do during the battle. He sort of has a plan, which we learn is sending Doomsday to the Phantom Zone, through the Phantom Zone, to imprison him there. As we know, Wonder Woman has shown up. Last issue, Superman asked her to take Lois and Jonathan to the somewhere safe, so they go to the Justice League satellite. This issue, she sort of shows up at the last minute, you know, with the urgence of both Lois and with the urgings of Lois and John to go help Superman, because he does need help. He has his plan, but he hasn't have the time. You know, Doomsday hasn't really allowed Superman any breather, so he needs time to sort of set his plan in motion. And Superman and Wonder Woman showing up just at the right moment allowed Superman to get those minutes that he those. Few seconds that he needed to finally turn on the Phantom Zone projector and send him to the Phantom Zone. Then that's pretty much the first half of the issue. The second half is really sort of dealing with the aftermath, of the attack, you know. Superman goes and confronts Luthor. We learn some really interesting things about Mr. Oz. That final page is quite intriguing, actually. It sort of doesn't answer the question of, did Mr. Oz send Doomsday? Where did Doomsday come from? Where did this version of Doomsday actually come from? Who had him? How did he come to be in this, you know, in the current DC universe? We don't get those answers, so that's a little more intriguing to it. There's quite intriguing actually. And there are some interesting details there about Superman that CBR sort of pointed out in an article that they wrote, which is it seems Superman has super intelligence, super memory, which was much more common during the, the pre-crisis, during the Silver Age, Bronze Age era of Superman, a little bit in the Golden Age as well. And it's not that it's new for Rebirth. Back around 10 years ago, back in 2006, after Infinite Crisis, after the 1 year later story, during that 1 year off, during the time of 52 between, at the end of Infinite Crisis, Superman had lost his powers, and when he regained them, especially in Kurt Busiek's run, part of that super intelligence had returned, sort of super memory as well, but was never really brought up a lot. So here we sort of learn he has some super memory and some technical scientific skills that weren't exactly common to this version of Superman. As we learn, he built that fortress in the mountain, which is a nice callback to both the Golden Age Superman's mountain citadel that showed up in the early 40s, and the original Silver Age Fortress of Solitude, which was also built on the side of a mountain. Oh, sorry. But I really enjoyed this issue. Sort of like a nice wrap up. The art, I like the art. It sometimes looks a little beat up, but just a few, just at times. Nothing too serious or too distracting. So yeah, great issue. Can't wait for the next one, which will deal with the second Clark Kent that showed up, or the third, I don't know, Clark Kent that sh has shown up. Also, I also like that throughout this arc, especially the last issue, kind of tied in into the Superwoman book. I believe the Superman issues, the story going on in Superman, took place after, like, let's say, after this issue, sort of in between this issue and probably the next issue of Action Comics, because really, it's not as clear, but when it really takes place, but seeing that this arc started with Clark and Lois and John moving into their new home, in Superman they're pretty much settled in. This story could have taken place within a day, just a few hours during the battle. So after that they could have just settled in, and so it's not as clear in the continuity as I would like, but it sort of makes sense as well. Next up, Hal Jordan and the Green Lantern Corps. Well, the Green Lantern Corps has returned since probably at the end of issue one. Last issue, John Stewart sent Guy Gardner to sort of see what on the scouting mission. We don't really know where he is, as the rest of the issue sort of is dealing with Hal Jordan and his battle with the Sinestro Corps, which finally seemed to overwhelm overwhelm him, and we kind of learn that Sinestro's sort of policing. I mean, he claimed that the new force of law and order would be the Sinestro Corp. They're pretty much just getting people afraid to build this thing called the Fear Engine, and they're really not helping protect the universe. And so they need Hal Jordan. They want Hal Jordan, you know, Sinestro actually ordered them to capture Hal. They want him to fuel that Fear Engine thing that they're talking about, and they're actually able to capture Hal. So not a lot of stuff happened, I think. We did learn that the Sinestro Core rings actually are fueled by fear, but they don't really have a limit. As long as you can bring fear and cultivate that fear and reap that fear, it fuels their rings beyond, you know, just 100%. So that's probably the thing we've learned so far. Next up, Wonder Woman. Another good issue. The last part of this story, I really felt not much happened as much as I would like, but this one was really good. Finally, we get Wonder Woman, you know, come rescue Steve Trevor. You know, she and Cheetah go to the temple where they are trapped. We're also reintroduced to an old Batman character, Sacha Bordeaux, who seems to be working for somebody else, though she also seems to be connected to Argus. So it was a lot better than the last part of this issue, which I felt, of this story, which I felt was rather slow. So yeah. Then we have Flash. Flash number 5. Well, Godspeed isn't dead, which is good, because throughout most of this issue they thought they had defeated him, Godspeed, after they took down Dr. Carver the last issue. And I thought if that was the case, then that would have been a very, you know, not a very good ending. But no, Godspeed's still around. And for the most part, it was just, the issue focused on Barry, and, you know, Mina and the Speedster, you know, training and all that. And it wasn't until the very end that Godspeed shows up again, takes down the Speedsters, and apparently, something happened to Mina, which we don't know what happened to her. I think it's Mina, her name, I'm not sure. Let me check. Yeah, Mina. The art, I really, I wasn't too happy with the art, though. It's okay. The art is okay, but nothing to get excited about. You know, the characters sometimes they really looked weird. We also get a little bit more on Wally West getting, you know, training for his speed powers. So yeah, I'm still liking the Flash. Wish you could just sort of speed up a bit more. It's kind of like a really slow story. But I sort of like this sort of quiet issues, but nothing much happens until like the end. But you know, I would prefer that this sort of quiet issues come between arcs. not in the middle of the arcs. So those are the books I got. Finally, a back issue, which is Superman the Man of Steel number 26, which I talked about getting when I mentioned when I showed issue 25, and pretty much this completes at least the Superman side of the conclusion of the reign of the Superman, you know, the whole arc with the return of Superman after his death. Except I need to get Green Lantern number 46, which tied into this story for obvious reasons. Ghost City got blown up. And actually sort of goes between this issue and issue and Superman number 82. So now I have to look for Green Lantern number 46 and actually get the whole story. I've come across it a couple of times at my shop, but you know, it sort of pops up from time to time, or I just don't look for it hard enough. So that's it for this week. Next week there won't be any videos because I won't be getting any books. It's a fifth week, so no books coming out until the week after that. So between then and the next review video, I'll probably finally get to do the Suicide Squad review video, which I should have done this week, but I've been kind of busy. I didn't have much time, so I'll probably do that over the week, or you know, during the weekend, and finally get that thing off my plate. So until next time, everyone, keep smiling.